Good evening and welcome to the Arthur Ludlow Memorial Baths, Newport, for this year's finals of the All England Summarised Proust competition. As you may remember, each contestant has to give a brief summary of Proust à la recherche du temps perdu, once in a swimsuit and once in evening dress. The field has now narrowed to three finalists, and your judges tonight are Alec and Eric Bedser, ex-Surrey cricketers, Stuart Surridge, ex-captain of Surrey, Omar Sharif, Laurie Fishlock, ex-Surrey opening batsman, Peter May, the former Surrey and England captain, and Yehudi Menuhin, the world-famous violinist and the president of the Surrey Cricket Club. And right now, it's time to meet your host for tonight, Arthur Mee!
Good evening and welcome! Well, as Proust would say, la malheur imaginaire de recondition et de toutes celles, c'est bientôt la même chose. Remember, each contestant this evening has a maximum of 15 seconds to summarise à la recherche du temps perdu, and only Proust over here, you can see exactly how far he gets. So let's crack straight on with our first contestant tonight. He's last year's semi-finalist from Luton, Mr. Harry Bennett. There's the summarising spot. You're on the summarising spot. 15 seconds from now.
Proust's novel ostensibly tells it of the irrevocability of time lost, the forfeiture of innocence through experience, the reinstallment of extra-temporal values of time regained. Ultimately, the novel is both optimistic and set within the context of a humane religious experience, restating as it does the concept of intemporality. In the first volume, Swan, the family friend.
Well tried, Harry.
Unfortunately, he chose a general appraisal of the work before getting onto the story. And as you can see, he only got as far as page one of Swan's Way, the first of the seven volumes. A good try, though, and very nice posture.
Harry Baggett, you're from Luton?
Yes, Arthur, yes.
Now, Harry, what made you first want to try and start summarising Proust?
Well, I first entered a seaside summarising Proust competition when I was on holiday in Bournemouth, and my doctor encouraged me with it.
And, Harry, what are your hobbies outside summarising?
Well, strangling animals, golf and masturbating.
Well, thank you, Harry Baggett.
Well, there he goes, Harry Baggett. He must have let himself down a bit on the hobbies. Golf's not very popular around here.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Rutherford from Leicester. Are you ready, Ronald?
Yeah.
Right, that's a summarising spot. Right. You've got 15 seconds from now.
There's this house. It's in the morning. No, it's in the evening. And there's a garden. And this block comes in. What's his name? Oh, God, just said it. Big block. Swan!
Well, now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like you to welcome the last of our All England finalists this evening. From Bingley, the Bolton Choral Society and their leader, Superintendent McGough. All right, Bingley, remember, you've got 15 seconds to summarise Proust in their entirety. Starting from now.
Proust in his first book wrote about. Ambitious try there, but in fact the least successful of the evening. They didn't even get as far as the first volume.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I don't think any of our contestants this evening have succeeded in encapsulating the intricacies of Proust's masterwork. So I'm going to award the first prize this evening to the girl with the biggest tits.